You were out there, you did some training with Briggs, or how did that come about? You guys ran into each other?
Nah, yeah, I was out there with Lisa Porter. She was out there for her Golden Glove tournament, and we just needed a place to work out while we were there for the week. So we stopped by the Heavyweight Factory, and that's Shannon Briggs.
Let's go, champ.
Training grounds, yeah.
Hey, he's a beast, man. He's 43 years old, and he's still going. Isn't that impressive?
It is impressive, man.
Him and Hopkins, man, you know?
Yeah, it is impressive. And he brings a lot of energy, a lot of juice to the tables, which is cool and fun to see. So I love how he gets around all the people. You know, he takes his walks around the beaches, going into the stores, talking to everybody. So he's cool, man. He brought us a big smile on our face when we saw him, man. I hope he keeps it rocking, and I hope he gets what he wants.
I talked to him this morning on FaceTime, and he said that Tyson Fury, he's a superhero, and Tyson Fury's a pie.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Hey, man, well, he needs to start fighting guys like that. And, maybe he can
he can
shut up some of the critics.
What do you think about him chasing down Vladimir Klitschko, man? He's, like, hunting him down and everything.
That's good, man. Let's go, champ. I hope he gets what he's looking for.
Yeah. Victor Postol versus Matthysse, man. How do you see that fight playing out? StubHub Center, home of the upsets, fight of the year.
I don't know that other guy.
Postol.
Is he good?
He's coming off a big knockout. He stopped the guy that no one was able to even drop. So.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Dean, Turkish guy.
Well, no, I like Matthysse, though, man.
Yeah.
He brings the heat.
How do you see that fight playing out?
Again, I'm not very vastly knowledgeable on Postol. Postol.
A lot of people say that. Why is it? I mean, he just knocked out Sukarket Dean. And
I think maybe he just hadn't had the American exposure.
Yeah.
You know, and so I haven't really sucked him out to did a lot of research on him or anything. So I can't really speak too much. Matthysse has a bigger name, and most of the time. They had the exposure for a reason,
yeah.
Most of the time. So sometimes, you know, a guy does get overlooked and when he shouldn't. But I gotta believe that Matthysse is brought to the forefront more than Postol, probably for a reason.
Yeah.
So if you put a gun to my head, I have to pick Matthysse. But again, that's blind. Yeah. Like, I don't really know much about.
Yeah, there's already premature rumors. Bob Arum stated that the future opponents for Peggy could be Matthysse or Marquez 5. Which one would you prefer to see?
Oh, Matthysse. You know,
why not Marquez 5? I mean, it's always great fights, man.
Yeah, I've seen it so many times.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'd like to see him mix it up with Matthysse. That would be an interesting fight. Matthysse is going to... I don't know. Because Matthysse boxed Provodnikov. That was pretty cool.
That was impressive. Everybody thought he was going to go in there and just...
Yeah. He switched gears and boxed him. I was impressed by that. I'd like to see Matthysse get in there with Pacquiao, mix it up. I've been hearing rumors that with Pacquiao may not have much, you know, Roach was saying that he might want to think Pacquiao should retire if he doesn't do well. So, I don't know, maybe, I think Pacquiao in his prime will probably beat Matthysse pretty easily, but
now he'll have
now
trouble.
He's a little bit past it,
yeah.
So it might be like an exciting time.
Talking about retiring, Mayweather just retired, 49-0, it's official. How do you see him amongst the all-time greats?
He's up there, he's in the conversation for sure. Of our era, he's the greatest, you know.
So he is the greatest of our lifetime, right?
Of our era, yeah. I don't know if that's maybe mine in your lifetime, yeah, but some of these old-timer guys seen some greats too a lot. I don't know, it's just hard to say. It's hard to compare eras because it's different. Like, you take a guy like Floyd Mayweather, he had 49 fights. 49 all fought great fighters of his generation. But then you look at a guy like Sugar Ray Robinson. This guy had over 200 professional fights. How can you compare the two?
That's true.
You know,
it's incomparable.
You can't, because it's a different time. And these guys are fighting every week, a couple times a month, you know. Fighting and skipping big weight classes and not picking and choosing a guy.
Yeah.
Like Mayweather would go to 154 to fight a certain person but not another person.
Yeah.
I understand it. Mayweather's not even a real welterweight.
Yeah.
I think if Mayweather was around with Sugar Ray Leonard and Tommy Hearns, he's 140 pounder or 135 pounder.
Yeah.
Them other guys are
he wouldn't have moved up.
So Tommy Hearns and Sugar Ray Leonard, they're 5'11", 6 feet tall and fast and athletic and know how to box. I don't think Mayweather would go around and mess around with those guys. Not to say that he couldn't make a good account of himself.
Yeah.
I just don't think he would have done it.
What?